If you're using AI just to write emails, you are wasting your potential. You're bleeding time, you're making slower, dumber decisions, and worst of all, missing out on a more fulfilled life. I'm David, and these are 7 life-changing ways to use AI so you feel in control at the end of the day, not buried under it. Number 1, think back to the last really hard decision you had to make. Maybe you're going to quit your job or even decide to marry someone. Who'd you turn to for advice? Your friends, your family? Well, they mean well, but their advice isn't always enough when the stakes feel life-altering. So here's an alternative to stop you spinning. Go to ChatGPT.com because we're going to ask the AI for some advice. In the prompt box, the first thing you'll do is tell ChatGPT to act as your board of directors. Then add a line for every one of your heroes or role models, as well as their area of expertise. Once you finish adding your board, tell ChatGPT you're seeking advice on the following situation. If you want your advice in a specific format, you can add more detail here, like you want a pros and cons list. Then drop in your dilemma and hit enter. Make sure you provide all of the context about your situation and the actual question that you want help on. Then watch ChatGPT reply in character. Every voice from your board gives you advice that you may not have considered before. Just like getting personal coaching from your heroes in 30 seconds. Now let's take this one step further, because sometimes the advice you get won't sound like your heroes at all. That's because ChatGPT pulls from outdated or even shallow summaries of these people's work, so it misses the mindset, the nuance, the edge that actually made them your hero in the first place. So if your board of directors sounds like a motivational poster, do this. Head over to notebooklm.google and click on Try NotebookLM. Then click the Create New button. NotebookLM is a simple way to build an AI model that's only trained on the content, the sources that you provide it. So if I want to get more recent and more specific advice from Alex Hormozy, I might go to his channel and pick out a couple of videos that I like and copy their links. Then back in NotebookLM, I can choose to add these YouTube videos. And after I add them all, I can get answers on 10 plus hours of content in literally a fraction of the time. The response is comprehensive and has a number of citations back to the source material. Click on any gray circle with a number in it to find the original source content. Number 2, the last time I went through a brutal breakup, I was a wreck. I was replaying the good moments over and over. I was obsessing over how to win her back. It was awful. Now, ChatGPT didn't exist then, but if it did, this is what I would have listened to instead of another sad playlist. Go back to ChatGPT and enter the following prompt. I just went through a breakup. This time, act as a therapist and help me process this. Start with one question. This one line unlocks a judgment-free zone where you can start processing. Now, in this whole conversation, ChatGPT will be nice to you. But when you're ready for the truth and not just comfort, type in the following prompt. Just say, stop giving me sympathy and be honest. Now listen, this is not a replacement for therapy, but it could give you the breakthrough that you need. Number 3, I've worked 6 days a week, 50, 60 hours for years, but a recent conversation with my wife hit me hard. We've been so focused on pushing forward, but we stopped aiming at something meaningful. We kept saying we're doing all of this for our future family, but honestly, that wasn't enough. We didn't want to wake up in 20 years and just realized we missed life. So here's how we snapped our dream life back into focus. We're back in ChatGPT, and this time I want you to take a minute to type in your goals and your time frame for those goals. When you've finished, wrap it up with this request. Tell me a story of a day in my dream life as my future self who has this already. After one click and a few seconds, you've got a vivid picture of what you're fighting for. And now that you've seen it, you won't settle for less. Now, don't make the mistake of leaving it inside of ChatGPT. Print it out, put it somewhere you'll see every day, and watch how much harder you'll fight for that future. Time to shift gears because AI isn't just emotional. It can be a lifesaver for your business. When I started mine, everything felt under control until tax season hijacked my time and my focus. I was stuck reliving the entire year, one receipt at a time to avoid screwing up a return. Then I found QuickBooks Online, made by the sponsor of today's video, Intuit. I connected my bank account and credit card, and it started tracking all of my income and expenses automatically. It even learned how I categorize expenses. So by the time tax season rolls around, the work's basically done. Now I see cash flow in real time without having to input a thing. And it's about to get even better. QuickBooks is launching AI agents that take on tasks like invoicing and lead tracking for you starting July 2025.
If you're running a business, hit the link in the description below for a big discount on your first 3 months of QuickBooks Online. And as a user for over 5 years, trust me, it's worth it. Number four, at my last startup, a customer once emailed us furious, saying that a feature we built for them didn't meet their needs. That confused me though, because we had several meetings discussing what it should do and what it shouldn't do. And I thought we had agreed, but the meeting notes were vague on this specific issue and there was no recording, just two sides convinced they were right. So trust was broken. Now, I don't rely on my memory. I document all my meetings with AI. I'm a fan of two tools, Fathom and Plaud.
Fathom automatically joins every Zoom or Google Meet and it starts recording everything from the small talk to the key decisions. Plus, you can even use the built-in clip capture to tell it exactly what you want to highlight. After the call, Fathom gives you a full transcript, a clean summary, which includes key takeaways, as well as next steps or action items, as well as a full video recording of the conversation. And yes, it plugs right into your CRM. But one of the ways it really stands out is through the Ask Fathom feature. Here, you can talk to an AI that knows everything about this meeting. For example, I remember Jessica telling me about some injury she's experiencing, but I don't remember the specifics. I can just ask the AI about it and get the answer back immediately.
Plaud, on the other hand, records all my in-person meetings. It's a small device that you just press and hold to start or stop recording. It's perfect for situations like doctor's appointments where you can't quite catch everything in the moment. So now my entire meeting history is searchable. It's like a personal database. And if a client disputes what I say, no problem. The recordings are right here. Great news is both of these apps are free, but yes, you do need to pay for the Plaud device itself. Number five, 2 years ago, if you had a great app idea, but you couldn't code, it didn't matter. You'd pitch, beg, or wait while someone else decided if your vision was worth building. But now the game's changed. You don't need permission and you don't even need to code, just a clear vision. If you know what you want, just do it.
And here's how. You've probably heard people say you can use ChatGPT to code. And that's true. It does work with simple app code. But here's the problem. Even with working code, most non-technical people struggle getting this code online. Now, before we go solve that problem, let's make sure you understand what you just saw. I prompted ChatGPT to create a template gallery of AI use cases. Then I defined what a template is. It should have a header image, title, brief description, list of tools, and a tutorial. Then ChatGPT created all this code, which looks cool, but let's check it out using this preview button in the top right. We get a simple web page with a couple of sample templates. And when we click on View Tutorial, we get a simple step-by-step. You could keep prompting to make this app better, like you could fix these images and make the surrounding UI look a lot nicer. But when you're done, all you have is a single file. What do you do next? That's why I'd recommend a specialized app building tool called Lovable. It's one of the best AIs out there for beginners, especially if you've got zero coding experience. All you have to do is sign in and then describe what you want to build. I'll use the same prompt I sent to ChatGPT. Let's see what's different this time. Now, within seconds, Lovable starts thinking through the structure so you can see why it's making certain design choices and how you can provide more detail to prompt better next time.
So after literally 2 minutes, it's brought my idea to life, bigger and bolder than I expected. So let's try this out. First off, the title could use a little bit of work, but at least we have one to introduce the gallery. Scrolling down, you'll see it's created template categories, which we can click on to filter. It also added some creative ideas like a difficulty system and a time taken. And when we click on a template, we should see tutorial details, but all we have is the hover image right now. This actually looks like a bug, so I'm going to tell Lovable about it and see what it can do to fix it. It found the issue and very enthusiastically fixed it, and I don't even have to refresh the page. I can see that it's working. Now you can get started with Lovable for free, and with it, you're not just creating something useful, you're building something that actually looks good.
Now you have no excuse. If you ever say, I have an app idea, stop talking, just get started. Number six, one of my mentees was struggling to get a job recently. She got a lot of first interviews, but never second interviews. She felt stuck and worse, like maybe she wasn't good enough. So we tried everything together. We tried mock interviews. We tried giving direct feedback, even scripts and memorized stories. They helped, but not fast enough to change the outcome. And then I found a better tool for her, Google Gemini.
And here's how. For this demo, I'll need to use the Gemini app from the App Store. So earlier, I downloaded a job description on my phone, and now I'm going to upload it to Gemini using that plus icon and then tapping on Files. This is a real job description for a TikTok product manager. Okay, now that I've attached it to my prompt, I'm going to ask Gemini something very specific. I want to practice a mock interview based on this job description. Let me know when you're ready to ask the first question, and I'll change to live mode. Let's submit this. It should be fairly quick to get a response. Okay, it's ready to go. I'm going to turn on live mode by tapping this icon in the bottom right corner.
Great, let's get started. Based on the job description, it looks like TikTok is looking for someone with a strong background in user growth and e-commerce. Can you tell me about your experience in these areas and how they relate to the responsibilities outlined in the job description?
So with this mock interview, you'll notice that the questions are specific to the job description. Answer it as if you're in the real interview, and then once you're ready for feedback, ask for a real critique on how you did.
That's impressive growth. Building an app from scratch and reaching 20,000 users in 10 months demonstrates a strong understanding of user acquisition and engagement. Can you tell me more about the strategies you use to achieve that growth?
Sure, let's stop here. I'd like a real critique on how I'm doing so far.
Okay, based on your responses, you have a strong understanding of user growth and have achieved impressive results with your own app. To make your answers even stronger, try to connect your experiences more directly to the specific responsibilities and qualifications outlined in the job description. For example, when discussing your growth strategies, mention how they align with TikTok Shop's focus on lifecycle management, subsidy efficiency, and collaboration with cross-functional teams. This will demonstrate a clear understanding of the role and how your skills can contribute to their specific needs.
Number seven, let's talk about something everyone hates, getting slapped with a surprise bill. See, a few months ago, I got hit with a $150 charge for a checkup that should have been covered. No warning, just a bill. Now with ChatGPT's help, I figured out that what they billed for didn't match the reason for the visit. I asked it for help talking to my doctor's office and my insurance company, so I sounded like I knew their language. And then I called my doctor, and while on the phone, I was furiously typing in what they said so I could get real-time help from ChatGPT. Now they didn't budge, but I called my insurance company, got them on my side, and the office dropped the charge. I'm no insurance expert, but this saved me $150 that I didn't owe. I want you to take away one message today, and that is you have to use your imagination to use AI effectively. So go beyond rewriting emails and making funny photos to something truly life-changing, and let me know what you find. Thanks to Intuit for sponsoring this video. Be sure to check out the link in the description for a big discount off QuickBooks Online for 3 months. I'm David, and I'll see you in the next video.